Hey, my name is Taylor, and I am a juggler. When I'm not juggling, I'm a videographer and editor here in Los Angeles, but I mostly take videos of myself juggling. Why do I juggle? The answer to that question has changed a lot throughout my life. Originally, I learned how to juggle when I was 12 years old, and I got into it because I didn't have a lot of really close friends. You know, I think I was just an awkward kid. And so juggling was kind of the solution to that. It was a great way to feel like I was playing a sport without needing a bunch of friends. Juggling was my rock throughout high school. It was the thing that I could do when I felt alone, and that's why I used to juggle. And then I hit college and things changed. I got really stressed out with schoolwork. I got really busy. I had much less time to practice. I started getting really down on myself for not improving, and I started comparing myself to these other jugglers that I would see, like Wes Peden and Vova Galchenko. I started to dislike myself because I felt like I was never going to be as good as them. I felt like I was never going to be the technical juggler. I was never going to be the creative juggler. I just felt like, what was the point? So I stopped juggling for years. Eventually I moved to LA and I got really caught up in work, as people do. And I started to get really depressed. I struggled with depression for a couple years. And at my lowest point, I just felt completely overwhelmed by life. I felt like I wasn't making progress on anything. It was that same feeling that I felt with juggling 8 years prior, but now it was with every aspect of life. I just felt out of control. So I started trying to remember things that would make me happy, things that I could do that I used to really enjoy, and one of those things was making videos. I used to make videos on YouTube all the time of my juggling, and I had such a blast with it before I got all caught up in the comparing myself to others. I used to just really enjoy putting up a camera and showing what I was working on. And so I thought, okay, I'll do that again. So I created an Instagram account. I called it Juggle Every Day, and that was my goal. My goal was to juggle every day because that's what I used to do. I used to juggle and film it, so I'll do that again. So I started doing that. And no matter how much I didn't want to do it, every day I told myself, I'm gonna do it. And I did. There were days when I was super depressed and just felt like I couldn't get out of bed, but I still got out of bed for 10 minutes to film a silly juggling trick and post it online. And as I would do this every day, it started to really help my mental health, because no matter how much I felt like a complete loser, no matter how much I felt like I couldn't figure out my career or my relationships or whatever, at the end of the day, I can say that I did this one thing. I juggled today. I made progress on this trick today. And I posted it today. I made a video of it. Those things are all accomplishments, no matter how small they are. And it started reminding me of that. And it felt good. It felt like maybe things are manageable, even if it's just in this small way. And I think that's helped me so much. I think it really helped me manage the expectations of myself. And then the weird thing happened where I actually started really looking forward to juggling. All of a sudden, I remembered why I loved juggling in the first place, you know? There's something about the way that it makes you feel. It's meditative, it's calming, it's physical exercise, which is extremely important for me and, you know, anyone with depression. I love the feeling of pushing my body to get better, but in like small ways. And I love being able to see how bad I am at something here and then see how in a month I've gotten better. Like, that is such a powerful feeling. It is such a good feeling to know that you can get better no matter how much you suck. And that to me was the biggest lesson that juggling has taught me over the last year. It's just reminding myself that with anything, no matter how far gone you feel, every day you can make a little bit of progress and it'll get better. So that's why I juggle, because it reminds me of that, and because it's always there and it always has been.